Okay, so let's now look at the receiver part of the code. So as we see, the receiver part is very similar to that of the sender. We still have these memory accesses which are done, but the major difference here is that the block of memory accesses is actually timed. So the timing is done by this function called RDTSE. So this RDTSE function returns what is known as the timestamp. Prior to actually executing these instructions, we measure the timestamp, and also at the end of these instruction executions. Therefore, the end minus start would give you the time taken to execute these instructions. RDTSE function, as we see over here, uses something known as the RDTSE instruction, which is supported by all Intel platforms or Intel processors. So this instruction essentially reads a timestamp counter. All Intel machines maintain a counter. It's a 128-bit counter which starts at zero at the time of reset and increments at every clock pulse. So the RDTSE instruction then reads the timestamp counter at that particular instant. So we had two versions of this RDTSE function. The one is for 32-bit and the other is for 64-bit. And if you're using trying to actually replicate this particular covert channel on your own machine, you could suitably enable one of these two functions. So that being said, the next thing we actually look at is there is something known as a threshold, which is also defined. So the N minus start gives you the time required to execute these eight instructions, and we see that the time recorded for these, for this set of instructions, may be extremely noisy. The noise may come due to certain other aspects which are going on in the processor, for example page faults, interrupts and so on, and these needs to be filtered out. So the threshold value should be selected on a per processor basis or a per CPU per system basis, and it does not have to be very accurate. In this code, we have hash defined the threshold to a value of 1750. So this value should be good enough to filter out most of the noise due to interrupts and other aspects like context switches and so on, but yet be large enough to permit or to be able to distinguish between cache hits and cache misses. So for any of these timing which is less than the threshold, we maintain something known as a frequency distribution table and identify how often a particular time is observed. So at the end of this particular iteration, that is the time period, and recollect that the time period is set to 2^24, we use these frequency distribution tables to identify whether a cache hit or a cache miss is observed. Now, a cache miss would imply that the sender has actually sent something through that particular port. So it would mean that the sender has actually loaded something in that particular, in that corresponding set, and therefore has evicted the receiver data from that set. And therefore, when the receiver is actually accessing through that set, it would result in a cache miss, and memory access would require to be to go to a lower level cache like the L2, LLC or the DRAM to complete the memory access. So this would typically take longer, which we have timed, and this timing would actually show up in the frequency distribution. So in this way, by observing the various frequency distributions for the various sets 10, 20, 30 and 40, the receiver would be able to decipher whatever has been transmitted by the sender. So it would then be able to identify zeros and ones. It would be able to identify whether this was an odd bit or an even bit that the sender had actually transmitted. So in this way, what we have seen is two independent processes, a sender and a receiver, being able to communicate with each other through this covert channel, this very indirect channel, and being able to break all the security that is achieved by this underlying platform. Such covert channels may not be restricted only to the to a cache, but other aspects or other processor and system level features, such as in the file system, page faults, and other things like keystrokes and so on, may be also used as a source of a covert channel. Thank you.